Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us as net loss. There's net profit, and always the businessman do not want to hear this term called loss. Loss is such a word, you know, that embarks all their veins and the blood starts moving like anything. So net loss, every company doesn't want it to be there on their financial statements, that is on the profit and loss account. So let's start. What is the net loss? See, if a business incurs expense in excess of the revenues earned in specific time period, the loss incurred as a result is known as the net loss in the accounting balance. Now, if the revenue, that is R, if that is in excess of the expenses, it would result in net profit. Okay. If this is less, then net loss. Okay, fine. See, loss or net profit is usually recorded at the bottom of the income statement. Now, business can survive despite incurring this net losses by relying completely on the revenues earned during the earlier period or with the help of the loans. But it does not go without saying that the purpose of the business is to turn the profits eventually. So let me give you an explanation to the net loss. Fine, let's begin. See, it is also considered as an example of the matching principle. Okay, as revenues earned in a period and the expenses made against it are matched for that period, irrespective of when those expenses might actually be paid. If some of the expenses incurred in a specific period are not paid within that time period, it is called as the accrued expenses. So let's understanding the total expenses. Well, the total expenses can further be broken down into cost of goods sold, and then we have the operating expenses, okay, of all kind which are necessary to keep the business in operation. So COGS is the basic figure which must be covered in the revenue, and if for some reason, including increased cost of production, manufacturing issues, expensive equipments, or other factors, revenue might be exceeded by the cost of goods sold. So thus it results in loss. Assuming the COGS is covered by the revenues, there can always be some unexpected rise in the expenses that can be possible. So all of these factors can add to total expenses and should exceed the revenue. The net loss might result for some specific period also. So now let's say that what are the causes or impacts of such net losses. See, although this is not unusual for the business to suffer losses, continuing losses would result in lowered accrued earnings. Okay. And could necessitate extreme measure to cut down on operational or other expenses, which could include reducing the manpower or shutting down some of the manufacturing units or downgrading part of the operations, none of which would do well in terms of creating a positive image for the corporations in their consumer or investors. But still, at times, such drastic measures can help to tide over the particular difficulties period before a business can generate profits again. So along with this reasons, revenue can also fall below the expenses and cost of goods sold due to a strong competition, or ill-conceived pricing strategies, apart from the unsuccessful approach to marketing the products or service offered. So successful marketing programs are often considered as the, the best methodology or the best method for boosting sales and image of the business. So resulting in the net income and which would also be used for accrued earnings for the future quarters. And they support business operations in case, you know, if there is net losses due to some unforeseen reasons. Okay. Now let's get to head-to-head of for the case of the examples of the net losses. See, company, let's say ABC, let's say there's a company ABC that is that might earn a revenue closely around 150,000 in a specific period, and the COGS is 1 lakh, while expenses mount up to, let's say, 60,000 against the revenue earned. So formula for calculating the net loss is the total revenue minus total all expenses. Revenue minus all the expenses, 10,000 is the loss. As simple as that. So we are left with a negative cash of 10,000 after deducting the COGS and the expenses from the total revenue earned for that period. So in other words, company ABC registered a loss of 10,000 for the said period and would need to rely on the accrued earnings or additional resources to stay afloat and carry on with the future operations. So this happened due to the excess of expenses, which along with the COG has exceeded the total earnings of the said period. Now, how net loss influences the taxable income? Well, see, it must also be understood that losses might affect how a company files its taxes due to the way it can alter the taxable income in a specific period. But due to regional differences, you know, this might or this can happen. This is possible. And the taxable income might be brought down and business could receive tax refunds, which would also help them to keep their operations afloat. So, however, as already stressed, continuing losses would eat into the cash reserves and business might risk shutting down its operations if it fails to turn things around and to generate profit. Now, how the net loss is different from the gross loss? See, net loss must also not be confused with the gross loss, which is negative cash left after COGS is deducted from the net total revenue. Now, if the result is positive, it would be termed as the gross profit. And if the result is negative, it would be termed as the gross loss for that period. So, it is revenue minus the COGS. Now, whereas the calculating the net losses, one must deduct the COGS as well for all the operating expenses from the revenue earned in the period. So, which is arrived at simply by deducting the COGS from the revenue, but still it ends up with losses when expenses are also taken away from the gross profit. So, if a gross profit is registered, then the losses would also be higher. It is possible. And the gross losses on the same reason can be deducted expenses as well. So, finally, let me put my conclusions on this. See, net losses is not just another accounting term, but an important indicator of how well a business is performing. And it's called the bottom line. This is very important. Net loss is called bottom line and revenue is called the top line. Use this term in your practical life. Both practical, because it is mentioned at the bottom line of the income statement, also figuratively because of the significance in that, no matter what odds a business might be facing. But if it exceeds in generating profit, things are still looking up and vice versa the case. So however, it goes out without saying that, you know, it must not be seen in the isolation, because a number of times the net losses are registered simply as a result of some temp or transitory changes in the business operations or production facility, which might not be considered as a cause of concern for the future success of the business. So it is only when a continual losses are occurring due to inefficient marketing, sub-quality products, very expensive production, along with the other issues, that the business must take necessary action to turn things around to survive and prosper.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.